Welcome to another episode of the Bojuka Blog, where we talk Commander and even more. We have another four-player game ready to go today. Matt is playing Omnath, Locust of Rage. Omnath is a 5/5 elemental with a landfall trigger. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under your control, put a 5/5 red and green elemental creature token onto the battlefield. Whenever Omnath or another elemental you control dies, Omnath deals 3 damage to target creature or player. Matt has built this deck as the landfall nightmare of our playgroup. This deck is very strong and left unchecked can fill the board real fast. Harry is playing Yarok, the Desecrated. Yarok is a 3/5 elemental horror with Death Touch and Lifelink. As well, if a permanent entering the battlefield causes a triggered ability of a permanent you control to trigger, that ability triggers an additional time. Harry built this deck as a Panharmonicon deck with enough value to draw cards until he decks himself on occasion. Value, value, value. Tyler is playing Jalira, Master Polymorphist. Jalira is a 2/2 human wizard with the ability to pay 2 and a colorless. Tap Jalira to sacrifice another creature and reveal cards from the top of your library until you reveal a non-legendary creature and put that card onto the battlefield. Put the rest of the cards in the bottom of your deck in a random order. This deck is straightforward as it gets. Create tokens, manipulate the top of your deck, and then turn the tokens into big dumb creatures. Tom is playing partner commanders Vial Smasher the Fierce and Ludevic Necro Alchemist. Vial Smasher is a 2/3 Goblin Berserker that reads, whenever you cast your first spell each turn, Vial Smasher deals damage equal to that spell's mana cost to an opponent at random. Ludevic is a 1/4 human wizard that reads, at the beginning of each player's end step, that player may draw a card if a player other than you lost life this turn. This is a fun partner deck with Vial Smasher throwing random shots of damage around the board, while Ludevic encourages everyone to hit each other in the face until Tom's found a way to win. Thanks so much for joining us this week, and enjoy the game.
Here we go. Alright, I'm gonna draw. I'm gonna play a tap Cinderglade and pass the turn.
Good. Alright, I'm gonna draw.
I'm trying to go.
I will play a tapped Foul Orchard and pass.
Play an island. And then I will tap my island to play Siren Visions. So I'll draw a card. And then I'll scry 2. Okay, put that on top, put that on bottom. And then I have to go to discard, I believe. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards in hand. I will discard Sharding Sphinx.
Wait, 7 cards in hand?
Yeah, you said 7 cards in hand and you're discarding?
5, 6. Nah, I'm gonna take the Sphinx back because I'm an idiot.
What a great start to the.
That's like a.
Trying to help you.
Like a public scry to your graveyard? I don't know. What is that? Surveil?
Well, you're on a 5-turn clock, buddy. Yeah, Chardon Sphinx is coming.
Shit. Game over.
Alright. I drew and I'm gonna play a Steam Vents tapped and I'm gonna pass.
Okay. Untap. Draw. We're gonna play a forest and pass the turn.
And untap, we're gonna draw. We're gonna play a snow-covered island. We're gonna tap 2, and we're gonna play a Talisman of Resilience. It's the Golgari Talisman. And we'll pass.
Okay, untap, draw. I will play another island. I will play Memnite. He's a 1/1 artifact creature. And then I will tap 2 to play Scour All Possibilities, scry 2, then draw a card. Okay. I'm going to end up drawing this card and putting this one on the bottom, and then I'll pass turn.
I'm going to play a luxury suite, and I'm going to pass turn.
All right, I'm going to draw. All righty. We're going to play a mountain. I'm going to tap 3, play... All right, so She's still lost, but she's kind of seeking Azusa. And we're also going to play a terrain generator as my second land for turn. And then we're going to pass the turn.
Untap. We're going to draw. We're going to play a Morphic Pool. And then we're going to tap four, tapping this for colorless. I'm going to play a Guardian Project. Remember, a non-token creature enters the battlefield under my control. It doesn't have the same name as another creature you control, or a creature card in my graveyard, I draw a card.
Pretty powerful.
It's pretty good stuff.
Kill it, Tom.
I can't right now.
Right now.
Dun. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna tap two for See Beyond. Draw two cards, then shuffle a card from your hand into your library. Draw a couple cards here.
Sharding Sphinx
it is, for sure now.
Well, you technically didn't have to tell us that, but thank you.
I know, but I want you to know.
We knew it was going to be that.
I'm going to play Mishra's Factory for my land for turn. And then I'll pass turn. I'm going to shuffle this up.
Okay.
Thought it was going to be a Mishra's Workshop for a second.
I'm going to play a Morphic Pool as my land for turn. I'm going to tap three for, guess what? My first commander, Vial Smasher.
Yeah.
Tom, kill it.
Someone will. Go ahead.
Power Blast. Alright, I'm going to untap. Draw. That feels bad. Tap four here. My other friend, Oracle of Moldiah.
Jeez.
Hopefully we can get something here. Hey, look at that. It's a mountain. We get to play that. Let's see what the next one is. It's a forest. Oh. We're going to play that as well. Top card. Oh, it's a Multani. That's game. I guess with the two we just got for free, we'll play a Lotus Cobra. And no more landfall, so I'll pass the turn.
Alright, I will untap. I will feel not great about the turn that Matt just had. I'll draw a card.
Don't worry about it.
I'm
Tom's gonna
kill. I'm going to play a Snow-Covered Forest. And then I'm going to tap five. Play my commander. When he ETBs, he's going to trigger Guardian Project twice, so I will draw two. And then I will pass the turn.
Nice value, man.
What about that? All about that sweet, sweet value.
All of it.
That sweet, sweet.
Sweet, sweet value.
Play an island?
No way.
Yeah. I thought it was over. Tap four for Jalira. And then I will pass the turn.
I'm going to play Command Tower as my land for turn. I am going to tap three for my other commander, Ludevic, Necro Alchemist. It's going to trigger Vial Smasher. So Matt is going to be 1/2. Harry's going to be 3/4. Tyler's going to be 5/6.
Go low.
Matt, no, sorry, Tyler.
That's me.
He wanted it to be me, though.
Yeah.
Three.
So three.
Three, my lord.
Three, my lord.
So I'm going to go to my 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to go to my end step. Mm-hmm. I'm going to draw a card, and I have to discard one. I'm going to discard a mountain. Go ahead.
My turn? Alright, I'm gonna untap here. I'm gonna draw Multani, reveal the top. It's a mountain.
Oh boy.
Oh boy.
I feel ill. We're gonna go ahead and play said mountain. We have a landfall trigger. Let's get some dice up on this. We'll add a green. Reveal the top card. It's a Zendikar's Royal. Okay. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We've got 8 mana now. That's cool. I think we're gonna go ahead and play our commander. So, we'll tap out, leaving Cinderglade open to cast Omnath.
Yep.
My boy. And, with that, we'll pass the turn.
Alright, we're gonna untap. We're gonna draw. We're going to put Matt into Jund, and we're going to put Tyler into Dimir with an Urborg, Tomb of Yawgmoth.
Yes, that's what I needed. Game's over. I'm playing then... Tom's of Evictus.
We'll tap colorless, blue, and black. And we're going to play Limited All-Star Manowar.
Oh,
So we're going to have a couple triggers. So when it ETBs and we return a target creature, we're going to return Omnath to your hand.
Twice?
And then we're going to return Oracle of Moldiah to your hand as well.
Ooh. Oh, I really thought he was going to pick something else.
That's not very nice.
Well,
you don't get to see what's on top anymore.
And then Manowar is going to trigger off Guardian Project twice and draw me 2 cards. And then this is where I realized that this deck just ends up decking myself. I'm gonna play Tireless Tracker, which is going to trigger Guardian Project and draw me 2 cards. And then I'm going to move to discard because I have 8 cards, and that's number. It's not 7, Tyler. It's 8.
I was gonna say you're gonna get rid of 2 cards over there.
I'm going to discard a Snow-Covered Forest. Actually, I counted wrong. I was at 9, so I'm going to discard a second Snow-Covered Forest.
Oh, you turned 3 cards then.
Yeah. 6 is the maximum hand size in this pod.
I don't know the rules of this game anymore. What is happening?
House rules. Am I good? Alright. I'm going to draw for turn. Oh, that's pretty cool. Alright. I am going to... going to tap one of my islands I have here for Brainstorm.
You can tap it for a black if you want. I don't know if you want to. You can.
I'm going to then, and I'm okay. Can't play a Brainstorm now.
It doesn't resolve.
Alright, so I'm going to draw 3 cards and then put 2 cards on top of my library. I'm going to put let me see. Ooh, that's a good one. Yeah, I think I'll put that top. Oh, sorry. I'm taking my time. There we go. So put that on top. And then I will activate Jalira. I'm going to tap her, pay 3, sacrifice Memnite. And then I will reveal cards on top of my library until I get a non-legendary creature card and put that card into the battlefield. Let's hope the first one's exactly what I put there. Artisan of Kozilek, which doesn't have a cast trigger now, but it is a 10-9 with Annihilator 2.
Okay.
And I'll pass.
That's going to be fun.
Hey, Faster. Eric, you want to bounce that Limited All-Star anytime soon?
Yeah, let me get on that, and we'll make it happen.
Do you have a white main lion in your hand?
I'm going to play an island as my land for turn.
Forgot to play my land for turn.
I'm going to pay 3 for Commander Sphere. It's going to trigger Vial Smasher. Tyler, take another 3.
I don't deserve that.
You absolutely
do. Take an extra one.
I forgot to take. I forgot to put my land up for turn. I don't deserve it.
Alright, I'm going to go to my end step. Yeah, I'm going to go to my end step, draw a card off of Ludevic, and pass.
Alright, I'm going to untap. Dude,
this is why I didn't bounce Vial Smasher. Vial Smasher just loves Tyler.
No, yeah. It usually loves Matt. But
It's not a two-way street, that's for sure. It's definitely a love-hate relationship.
All right, I love Vial Smasher.
I'm going to draw this card that you guys don't know what it is.
Matt, next time you play that deck, can you stop kind of interweaving sleeves?
Which one's Omnath? You'll never know. Shit. We're gonna go ahead and run him out there again.
Run him out.
And with that, we'll pass the turn.
All right, we're gonna untap. We're gonna draw. Well, that's a spicy boy that I forgot was in this deck. I'm gonna play a Terramorphic Expanse. And I think we'll go black and black, colorless, and 3 colorless. And I'm going to play a Noxious Gear Hulk.
Oh.
So when it ETBs, I may destroy another target creature. I gain life to its toughness. So I'm gonna blow up that little Eldrazi friend.
He's not a friend of yours.
He's not your friend, Harry.
What was his toughness?
He was a 9.
And we'll go to 49. And then anyone have thoughts on what else I blow up?
Omnath.
Yeah,
since it's the highest power.
I'm voting Omnath.
Yeah, I'm gonna vote Omnath too.
Alright, I'll blow up Omnath.
Oh wait, I was supposed to say Yarok. Damn it. I'm an idiot.
Omnath is a 5/5?
Yeah. He was. Now he's dead.
Rest in peace. Then I'll draw 2 cards off Guardian Project. Then I will move to discard. And
so
I will
not attack him.
Discard another snow covered forest. Actually, I could attack. Oh wait, there. I played a land, so Tireless Tracker should have made 2 clues. Do I have clue tokens in here?
No. I got some. You want them?
I will use that for a clue right now. I think I have clue tokens somewhere. So I will send Yara at Tom.
Oh, you don't want to draw an extra card.
Correct. The answer to your question is absolutely. I'm burning through my deck at such a furious rate as it is.
And he's done enough to Tyler and I, so.
How big is Yarok right now?
3/5. Death Touch, Lifelink.
I'll take 3.
No, we'll gain 3. And I will pass the turn, and I'm going to go looking for some clue tokens.
Have a good time, man.
It'll be great.
I'm going to drop. Play one of these islands.
That's a nice island. You should have played that last turn.
I know, I should have played it last turn. I'm very sad about that. Okay, Tap 3 for my buddy Chasm Skulker.
Then I will tap two for the iconic scroll rack.
Whoa.
Okay, then.
Then I think I'm going to pass the turn.
All right, on your end step, I'm going to brainstorm. Roll for Vial Smasher. Tyler, take one. Draw three, put two back on top. I'm gonna put it back this way. I'm gonna untap, draw.
Wait, did you draw at his end step to Ludwig's trigger?
Tyler, you get to draw a card.
I get to draw a card too?
Yeah, because I did damage to you.
That's awesome. Ooh, that changed everything.
So I'm gonna play an island as my land for turn. I am going to tap five, including two black, for Archfiend of Depravity. Flying 5/4 at the beginning of each player's end step, that player chooses up to two creatures they control and sacrifices the rest.
And roll me up a deer.
Tyler?
How much is that?
Beating the deer, can you bring up, when you come back up, not right this second, piece of, buttered banana?
Well, I'm smiling over here.
Alright, I'm gonna go to,
Okay.
End step, and I'll sacrifice Ludwig.
Interesting.
Pass.
Okay. Whew.
Draw a card at my end step off of. I don't, because Ludwig's now gone. My apologies.
All right, I'm gonna draw. Play Cultivate, and I'm gonna go get basic forest to the battlefield tapped, which is gonna trigger Lotus Cobra. I'll add a green to my mana pool, then I'll get a basic mountain to my hand, which I can then just play for my turn, which I will then wait to do. Roll tap. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For Zendikar's Royal.
Ooh, that's a spicy one.
It's not bad.
Doesn't that turn lands into creatures?
Nope. Whenever a land enters the battlefield under my control, I put a 2/2 green elemental creature token onto the battlefield. I'll then play the mountain for my land for turn. I will add a green to my mana pool with that. And
you get an elemental?
I do, yeah. I was thinking if I could do something else here. Where are they? Where are they at? There they are. There he is. Swamp Thing. I guess with that, I'll just pass the turn.
Do you have to sack down to two creatures, Matt?
Oh, right. Yes, I do. I will sacrifice this newly born elemental. Good catch.
He had a brief life.
He did. He was a nice person. He will be remembered.
All right. We're going to untap. We're going to draw.
Did you give me half the bread?
No.
Thank you. I hope.
Sorry. Yarok is untapped as well. I think we'll play now standard All-Star, Field of the Dead. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lands with different names.
Ooh.
Two zombie friends.
And you get treasures too, right? I mean clues.
Yes, I get clues as well. All of this stuff makes more creatures.
They're all gonna go away, and they should get rid of that Archfiend of Depravity.
This is true.
Or kill Tom in one turn somehow.
Also true.
So we're gonna tap two green colorless. We are going to play God Eternal Ronus.
Uh-oh.
So that's going to double the power of each other creature I control until end of turn.
Uh-oh.
And then it's going to double it again.
Yep. See ya, Tom.
Yeah.
I don't think you're dead.
You're severely maimed.
Yeah, you're gonna be like
pretty
wounded,
you're bleeding out.
Right. So, what's coming at me?
So we're gonna send a 24 Noxious Gearhulk with menace.
Menace.
12-5 Yarok, an 8-2 Manowar, and a 12-2 Tireless Tracker.
Yikes.
Oh, sorry, they all have vigilance. My bad.
As if that wasn't enough.
Oh, God. Alright, so,
God Eternal, please. He was eternalized by Nicol Bolas.
Praise be.
Oh, sorry, Guardian Project also triggered and I draw two cards.
What's the power level again there?
So, 20... 12, 8, 12.
Lethal, unless you block.
Yeah, I'm gonna double block the
Menace guy?
Noxious Gear Hulk.
The Menace?
Yeah. It's gonna kill both of my creatures. And I'll end up taking 32 and go down to 5.
12-0. No, you only take... You do take 32.
Yeah.
I will gain 12, going to 69. That's right, kids.
And you're at 15 commander damage from Harry.
And the Noxious Gearhulk is still alive. I didn't have Death Touch or anything.
But it only has 4 power. Oh, sorry, only 4 toughness.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Yeah, it doesn't. It only doubles power, it doesn't double time.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not crit.
It is not. And I'm then going to tap two, and I'm going to play a Talisman of Curiosity. That is the Simic Talisman.
All right.
I will then pass my turn, and I have 7 cards, so I don't need to discard.
That's one card you got to get rid of.
The Yarok actually has a special rule. I get plus one hand size as well.
Oh, that's nice. You're good then. You're fine. I take everything back.
I'm good.
Plus one counter on Chasm Skulka. Skulka.
Get skulk.
Skulk. play an island for turn. So we got six. Yeah, it's pretty cool.
It's high tide time.
High tide. It's in this deck somewhere.
No, I mean, like, here at the beach, the tide's coming in.
Oh. I think man, I was going to play high tide and go nuts. Alright, I'll tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for Thopter Assembly. Flying 5/5. The end of my upkeep. If I control no Thopters other than Thopter Assembly, turn it to my hand and create 5/1/1 colorless Thopter artifact creature tokens with flying. So, with that, I think I'm gonna pass the turn.
Alright. So, what may be my last turn?
Ever.
Ever? You quitting?
This game sucks.
Anymore.
He's out.
Done magic. That was too rough.
Yeah, so
I'm gonna play Bloodstained Mire as my land for turn. Not crack.
He's killing himself with his land.
I'm just gonna leave it there.
Oof. Oh, there is an Urborg out, so that is a swamp.
That is true.
That's actually great for him.
Right. You don't have to crack it.
It's true. It's true. Although, I'm gonna pass the turn.
That's why I have this sweet, sweet Terramorphic Expanse that taps for black.
I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh no, I can do this first. Blue, red, and one. Okay. Yeah. So blue, red, and one for Fevered Visions. Beginning of each player's end step, that player draws a card. If that player is an opponent and has four or more cards, it deals 2 damage to them.
Alright.
That's the end of my turn, so I'm going to draw a card and pass.
Alright. Tom, that card is not making me want to let you live.
Yeah, I know.
Oh boy.
It's only 2 damage and you're at, what, 69 life? Come on.
He does have a point.
Just saying, you're not helping your case.
Yeah. You need to focus on someone else over there.
Oh, don't worry, I will.
I don't know who he's referencing, but I'm going to play... Let's see here. I'm going to tap 2 and 2 to play a Purphoros, God of the Forge.
Oh, boy.
Yeah? Is that sticking?
It resolves.
It resolves.
Blending? Okay, cool. I'm then going to play a Thawing Glaciers as my land for turn. That will trigger Lotus Cobra. I'll add a green to my mana pool. That will also trigger Zendikar's Royal. I'll make a Swamp Thing. And that'll also trigger Purphoros. So y'all take 2 damage, please. Then we're gonna use this green here, 2 red and a colorless, I guess, for Oracle of Moldiah. You guys will take another 2, and I'll reveal the top card. It is a Bane of Progress. Don't worry about the man behind the curtain. I will then go to end step and draw said Bane of Progress for Fevered Visions, revealing a Boundless Realms. Don't worry about that. And then I'll take 2 damage. Everything is fine.
Alright, we're gonna untap. We're gonna draw. I mean, we didn't come here to not draw cards, right?
You're supposed to draw cards. Just, you have to say it's 6 or less.
Yeah, 6 is the max.
Okay. This is gonna be dumb.
Discord rules.
So I'm going to play a command tower as my land for turn. That's going to make two clues, and it's going to make two zombies. I'm then going to...
Yeah.
I'm going to crack Terramorphic Expanse. I'm going to go looking for a snow-covered swamp.
Two more zombies.
That's going to come in tapped. We're going to make some zombies. We're going to make some clues. And then... this is where, you know, why not fly the closest to the sun, right?
Tom's at one. What are you talking about?
So this deck has lost multiple times due to decking itself. But I'm not gonna let that stop me.
Shoot your shot.
So we're gonna tap two colorless, three colorless, white, not a white, a green, a blue. We're gonna tap two more. That's seven mana. We're gonna play Tishana, Voice of Thunder.
Oh.
So she's going to ETB. She's going to draw me two cards off guard.
Hold on. Read what she does first.
Well, they're both ETB triggers.
He's stacking the triggers.
What does Tishana do?
Oh, sorry. Yes. So when she ETBs, she has power and toughness, equal number of cards in my hand. I have no maximum hand size when she's on the battlefield, and when she ETBs, I draw for each creature I can.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to,
doesn't seem like she's entering the battlefield.
A red and blue and three and, mind sweep you. Counter target spell unless its controller pays X, which is three, and it deals, X damage to that spell's controller.
Alright, I will take three. And she will be countered.
And now I die.
Yes.
A zombie is gonna take you out.
Yeah,
just one little zombie. That's
I should have countered Purphoros, but not that it really matters.
No, it wouldn't have mattered. I could have killed you with Tuvasa if I wanted to.
yeah, you could have killed me real easily.
I think I'm just gonna send
a zombie at me and kill me.
Yeah.
If you send anything bigger than a 2/2, that's just blasphemy.
Yeah, so I'm going to send Ronus at Matt. And I'm going to send... actually, there's four that are here.
How big is Ronus?
Ronus is a 5/5 Death Toucher. And then I'm sending... one zombie at Tom.
Oh yeah, I've already taken the damage, I'm dead.
There's one tapped and five untapped.
I will block with my Swamp Thing.
Okay. Then I will pass the turn.
Okie dokie.
Alright.
Boundless Realms time.
Draw for turn?
Draw. Oh, no, never mind. Not my turn. Yeah. JK lol.
That's something I would do. Don't do that. Alright, at my upkeep, this comes back to my hand and I get five Thopters. Five, sure. Okay. Alright, then I'm gonna tap one, two, three. For Ashnod's Altar.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm sorry, I drew a card as well, so that's not tick up Chasma Skulker. So then I will think I'm gonna pass the turn.
Interesting.
Life is very interesting.
Life is strange. Alright, now I'm gonna...
Like he's gonna... thought he was gonna draw Boundless Realms.
I was preemptively doing it on Tyler's turn, but now I'm so antsy to draw it, I'm just gonna draw it now when it's actually my turn. I'm gonna reveal the top card. It is a Perilous Forays.
Ooh, I don't love that either.
Not a land. All right. Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I guess 7. We're gonna shoot our shot. God hates a coward, as my welding teacher used to say. Boundless Realms on the stack, everybody.
I'm sorry, can you tell me what Boundless Realms is?
It is a 6-colorless, 1-green sorcery that reads, search your library for up to X basic land cards, where X is the number of lands you control, and put them onto the battlefield tapped, then shuffle your library. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Okay, I'm gonna respond to that.
Yeah.
By, I think I'm gonna sack, say, 3 of my Thopters here. So I'll sack 3 to Ashnod's Altar, so I get 6 mana in my mana pool.
Yep.
Just what I want to do with it, I don't know. And then I'm gonna tap. I'm gonna use 1 of that mana, so down to 5. I'll just keep track of it here, so I know I'm using 1 of it for a scroll rack.
Okay.
I'm gonna put. I'll put 4 on top of my library. I'm gonna draw 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Put these 4 on top. Okay. That's not gonna help either. That's not good. I still got 5 mana, so I'll use this island and 2 of this mana to activate Jalira while I have the mana in my mana pool here. I'll sack 1 more Thopter, and I will reveal Troma Caddis from the top of my library. 8/8, it's hexproof if it's attacking or blocking. It can't be blocked unless all creatures defending player controls block it. I think that's all I can do. I tried. I was hoping I'd get a counter, but I didn't. So.
All right. So, Balanced Realms is going to go off. I'm going to go get 10 basic lands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'll shuffle that in a minute here. Alright, so these all come in tapped. That's gonna trigger Lotus Cobra, Zendikar's Royal, and Purphoros. So I'll
20 damage, right?
Yes.
Okay.
I'll add 5 green and 5 red to Lotus Cobra. And then I'll get 10 of these guys. So yeah, 20 damage there. Okay, with the 5 green and 1 red, we'll cast Multani. So that's another 2 damage. Oh, shoot. I was supposed to reveal the top card when I finished that. Sorry.
I need to know what that card is.
Yeah, technically Multani hasn't been cast yet because I should have to reveal this card.
If it's a land, I'm dead. I think, right? You can just play it.
Yeah, because I never played a land this turn. It is Sylvan Awakening, so you're not dead. Yeah, and with that, I'm going to pass the turn.
All right. I don't know if I can... Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. On your end step, I am going to crack a clue to draw a card. My bad. We're just going to put... Counter... Actually, I'll replace that 5. I need the spin downs. Sorry, guys. Left all of my dice at work. Didn't think the pandemic was going to stop me from getting them. I'm going to draw a card. Then we're going to untap. Six there. We will draw for turn. I don't know if I can stop Matt.
For what it's worth, Multani is a 20/20 with reach and trample. Just...
Correct.
So y'all.
You also have what? 10 2/2s, 10 3/3s?
10 2/2s as of right now, yes.
All right, so we're gonna play a snow-covered forest that is going to make some clues, make some zombies. His life total is just too high. So I guess we'll start by going colorless, colorless, black. Sorry. Can't be a black. It's gotta be two blue. I'm gonna play a Whirler Rogue. When it ETBs, it's going to make 4 Thopters. So we're just in make as many blockers as possible. I'm gonna draw 2 cards off the Guardian Project. Then I guess we'll just go. I don't think this is gonna matter. We'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're gonna play a Deep Forest Hermit. That's right, we're busting out some squirrels.
Yeah.
This is a weird card with Vanishing 3, so enters with 3 time counters on it. When it ETBs, I create 4, which becomes 8 squirrels. They're going to sadly be elementals because I don't have a squirrel token on me at the moment. So we're going to make 8 squirrels. Squirrels get +1/+1 when the Deep Forest Hermit is out. And I will draw 2 cards off the Guardian Project. None of this is all that helpful. So I will sadly go to my discard and dump this and beg for Tyler to come save me.
That's what I'm here for. What up? Alright. Actually, I was hoping that my draw for turn would help us, but I already know what it is. Scroll it.
That's the.
I was like, here we go.
The downside of scroll rack.
Exactly what I expected. Alright, play an island for turn.
What could it be?
Ah, man. There is. I don't know.
Well, if you kept the land in your hand, you could have scroll racked deeper than you did last time.
I got another option, maybe. I don't know, we'll see if I even have enough mana to pull this off, but I'm gonna go for it. I'm going to tap. Well, I'm going to sacrifice the Thopter to get two mana into my mana pool on Ashnod's Altar.
Yep.
So two mana with that, two mana and these three islands. I'm going to play Future Sight. So I will play the top card of my library revealed. I may play the top card of my library. So the top card of my library right now is Phyrexian Ingester. So... Perforos isn't a creature,
he's,
right?
He's not active right now.
If he was a creature, you'd be in some trouble.
Would I, though?
Oh, I'd be able to ingest him. It exiles.
Oh, right.
It exiles a creature, though. That's the problem.
Yes, so, I strategically do not have him as a creature right now.
You're good. You're so good.
I try.
All right, let's... I gotta try to get through my deck. So, I'm going to... I'll tap a blue for High Tide. Now it is High Tide time.
Yeah.
I should have done that right first before I get Future Sight, but I'm stupid. That is fine. So I will sacrifice Chasm Skulker and the three Thopters that are, or the three squid creatures that are going to be created. So that'll be four creatures. So I'll get eight into my mana pool. So eight in my mana pool now. Let's see. So I'll tap two and use five. So I'll go down to six. Man, I'm losing my mind. 8 minus 5 is 3 all day.
Still. Okay. Yep.
To play Phyrexian Ingester. Does that make sense? Yeah, 2 plus 5 is 7. Yeah. Okay. I'm losing my mind. I'm going to exile Multani. And he gets plus X plus Y, where is. That's Multani's power. Uh-oh.
Tapping down Glaciers for a colorless, because of Verbal. Ah. Tapping this for a green to play Heroic Intervention.
Oh, that's pretty good, man. That's pretty good. So he still enters the battlefield as a 3-3. He just doesn't do the
exile. He doesn't get the plus X and plus Y thing.
Okay. The next thing on top is Thopter Assembly. Man. Alright, so I still get 3. I'll use this 3 mana. 5. No, 3. So 3 mana. I'll sacrifice Phyrexian Ingester to get 2 more, so that's 5. And then I'll even sack Jalira to get 2 more. I'll have 1 floating. To play Thopter Assembly.
Yep.
I'll get Surge for Escanta. Great, that's helpful. Right, I'll tap my blue for... I'll use this. I'll have 1 floating blue mana left to play Surge for Escanta. Reveal Psy. Okay, I'm done. I'm gonna sack this Thopter Assembly, I guess, to Ashnod's Altar to get 2 more, and then use my open blue to cast Psy.
Yep.
Revealing Minds Aglow.
Oh, damn.
And I can't cast that because I'm out of blue mana here. It's alright. And then, you know what? I'm gonna attack you, man, with Trumptosis, whatever. It's an 8-8, and it has hexproof as long as it's attacking or blocking, and it can't be blocked unless you block it with all of your creatures.
Alright, I'll take it.
Alright, I'll pass turn.
Oh, we got him. We got him on the ropes, Tyler.
I'm in lethal range now.
I tried my best, man.
You did better than me.
Alright.
That's rarely said.
I will draw my Sylvan Awakening, which makes all my lands creatures for what it's worth. And then I will reveal the top card. It is a Blasphemous Act. I don't think I should do that.
Do it!
No balls. You won't!
Just kidding.
Well, we're gonna shoot our shot here. We're gonna cast Sylvan Awakening.
That doesn't trigger Perforos, right?
No, they were already on the battlefield, so they don't eat DB. Yeah. So now all my lands are 2/2 elemental creatures with reach, indestructible, and haste. They're still lands.
Yep.
All right. And then I will move to cast Craterhoof Behemoth.
Okay.
Is that a goodbye you, Harry?
I mean, it's not good, but it definitely will murder my face.
Okay, cool.
Okay, cool. That was good. Oh, man.
Hey, why is Craterhoof Behemoth $50? That's exactly why, right there. The perfect turn 10 game ender to make for a quick scoop on the other side of the board. Tom found his way into becoming an early target by springing an Archfiend of Depravity onto the board. Tyler cycled through a bunch of creatures that solved none of Matt's board state, while Harry showed just how strong Yarok can be when he is driving through Valiant Town. In the end, Purphoros and Craterhoof show exactly why we spend money on good cardboard. Thanks again for watching, and if you enjoyed the content, please like, subscribe, and keep an eye out for the next episode of the Bojuka Blog.